In today's lecture, we will define and describe surveying the dental cast. Surveying the dental cast is a diagnostic aid in treatment planning for the removable partial denture. Surveying identifies modifications of oral structures that are necessary to fabricate a removable partial denture that will have a successful prognosis.
The items you will need to survey the cast are the surveyor, surveyor table, and surveying tools. The surveyor consists of a base or platform, vertical arm, horizontal arm, and a vertical spindle or mandrel. The vertical spindle moves up and down and is secured with a lock knob. The cast is secured to a swivel table with a locking pin. A small collet on the vertical spindle is used to secure the analyzing rod, undercut gauges, cutting tool and carbon marker.
Surveying is useful to determine the most desirable path of placement that will eliminate or minimize interference to placement and removal. When this path is perpendicular to the occlusal plane, forces may be directed down the long axis. Because patients may seat the partial denture by biting, a path other than perpendicular to the plane of occlusion may result in tooth trauma or damage to the partial denture.
Path of placement is the direction in which a restoration moves from the point of initial contact of its rigid parts with the supporting teeth to its terminal resting position. The path of removal is exactly the reverse. With a well-defined path of placement, the patient may place the partial denture with ease, in only one direction.
When the restoration has positive guide planes, the partial denture may have a unique path of insertion and removal. Lingually tipped teeth and bony exostoses may interfere with placement of the partial denture or prevent the use of a particular component. A decision must be made to surgically remove the interference or use a different path of insertion. Ideally, retention is uniform through the selection of undercut or type of clasp. Evaluate for embrasure symmetry, dark triangles, and the aesthetic effect of guide plane preparation. In most cases, fixed restorations should be considered for anterior modification spaces.
Areas of tooth structure which can be made parallel for use as guide planes. Guiding planes give the partial denture a definite path, ensure predictable retention and component seating, as well as provide frictional resistance to dislodgement of the partial denture. This allows one to ask, what must I do to make these abutments parallel?
Guiding planes are prepared axial surfaces of the teeth against which the removable partial denture glides, as it is inserted and removed from the mouth. They should be parallel to the path of insertion. Guiding planes curve buccolingually to follow normal tooth contour. Guiding planes are parallel to each other and are 1/3 to 2/3 the clinical crown height.
Undercut suitable for retention is generally located in the gingival 1/3 of the tooth. Retention may be located either buccal or lingual. The amount of undercut may be determined with an undercut gauge. Retention should be balanced when possible and opposed across the arch. That is, buccal retention on one side is opposed by buccal retention on the contralateral side.
The example demonstrates a soft tissue undercut is avoided by tilting the path of insertion. In the case of lingually tipped premolars, the lingual bar would violate the tongue space. Either extensive restorative treatment or another major connector could be used.
The illustration demonstrates how embrasure spaces may be managed to improve the aesthetics of the partial denture. Great care must be exercised when forming anterior guide planes. Gross undercuts in the anterior alveolus may be eliminated by anterior posterior tilting of the cast. These modifications may be the deciding factor in establishing the path of insertion.
At the time of surveying, decisions regarding possible restorative procedures prior to manufacture of the partial denture are formulated. Areas of restoration and recontur may be simulated on the cast. In general, if can be done satisfactorily on the cast, it can be done in the mouth.
After consideration of guiding planes, interferences, retention and aesthetics, the height of contour of the abutment teeth is marked with the graphite marker. This mark is known as the survey line. A height of contour may be adjusted in cases where it would interfere with or compromise component placement. Common areas are the distal of lower premolars and the mesial of molars. The tilt of the cast determines the location of the survey line. The area superior to the line is called suprabulge. Below the survey line is called infrabulge. Hence, the infrabulge clasp approaches the undercut from below the survey line. The path of insertion is recorded by a method of tripodding. Scoring the cast in discrete areas allows duplication of the cast and orientation of the duplicate cast in the established path of insertion. This facilitates simulated tooth preparation, manufacture of a temporary partial, placement of blockout material or other diagnostic procedure.
This chart provides a summary of the purposes of surveying.
The zero tilt position is convenient for several reasons. With proper design, axial forces are distributed down the long axis, and seating under biting force is less likely to result in tooth trauma. Such an orientation is most helpful for the operator as well as the patient.
A correctly trimmed cast is attached to the survey table. The base should be flat, with no rocking. The occlusal plane is level with the table. That is, it is at zero tilt. Tilting the cast anteriorly and posteriorly is performed until the most favorable alignment of potential guide planes is located. Bony protuberances and misaligned teeth are examined and noted. Areas of possible retention are analyzed. Lateral tipping may be used to relocate the undercut relative to the height of contour. By doing this, a preferred clasp may be employed. It should be noted that undercut cannot be created by tipping the cast.
The illustration demonstrates how tilting alters the position of the survey line. Alteration may facilitate a more conservative design. In the following slides, we will discuss the basic surveying procedure.
The cast is secured at zero tilt. Interproximal and lingual surfaces are examined for areas that are, or can be, made parallel. The cast may be tipped anteriorly and posteriorly. What is required to parallel the tooth surfaces? Options range from minor enameloplasty to restoration with fixed crowns.
The analyzing rod is positioned in the superior one-third of the tooth. The cast may be tipped, if needed, to determine how best to align the tooth surfaces. In this case, guiding planes may be created by minimal preparation.
After locating suitable guiding planes, the cast is examined for potential areas of retention. buccal and lingual surfaces between the line angles are examined. Areas in the gingival one-third, apical to the survey line, are preferred.
Useful undercut areas are measured. Cast clasps require 0.01 inch retentive undercut, whereas wrought wire requires 0.02 inch undercut. If more attention is desired, it is preferable to clasp more teeth than to increase the depth of undercut on a given tooth.
When areas of potential retention have been identified and measured, the cast may be tipped laterally to relocate the desired undercut if necessary. Retention is bilaterally opposed and equal in magnitude when possible. It is important to recall that undercut cannot be established by simply tipping the cast.
The cast is tilted laterally to redistribute the undercut. The undercut may be undesirable, requiring extensive modification of the treatment plan. Severely tipped teeth and bony protuberances are common. The interference may be treated easily, but first must be identified.
If the interference is unilateral, it may be addressed by altering the path of insertion. Such a path may complicate the rest of the treatment plan. Finally, assess the impact of aesthetics. Dark triangles may be eliminated without excessive tooth reduction by altering the path of insertion. Gross anterior undercut may be eliminated by tipping. This orientation may have a dramatic effect on overall design. After evaluating the cast, mark the height of contour with the graphite marker. This is called the survey line. Note the position of the line. Occasionally it is necessary to adjust the height of contour. Often, a survey line in the middle one-third of the tooth is most convenient. Areas of tooth preparation may be noted in red. Note areas of retention with a red dot.
Tripodding the cast allows one to remove the cast from the table if necessary, then replace the cast at the same orientation. Tripodding may be done in several ways.
Red marks indicate the area of proposed axial tooth reduction.
The master cast is surveyed to ensure all mouth preparations are satisfactorily performed. If adequate, the cast may be sent to the dental laboratory for framework manufacture.
In this lecture we have described the armamentarium for surveying, examined the rationale for surveying, and provided basic instructions for surveying the dental cast. A companion video is available which demonstrates a very basic procedure. Thank you.